I want to take this opportunity, and it's a very special occasion for me, to warmly welcome the UNICEF country representative, Mr. Werner Schulz. I don't know how to pronounce his name. Excuse me if I mispronounce. Mr. Werner Schulz. And I think I would request you to start so that we all see you. We are used to many other different faces. It's your first visit to KEMSA, Werner. And welcome, Werner, to KEMSA. And if you are new in the country, also welcome to Kenya. And we are a family, KEMSA and UNICEF. We are a family, and we appreciate the partnership. We appreciate the family relationship, which has a purpose, and we will talk about it. And thank you for honoring us this morning. And also for my colleagues to have left their duties and be here with us, the managers, the directors, and even the members of the fourth estate who are here with us. Thank you so much, because you play a very important role in educating the public on what we are doing. I just want to take a few minutes just to say who KEMSA is and what our mandate is. I really don't want to take you through the details. I think it's enough to say, Werner, if I say that KEMSA is a medical logistics organization, is a public medical logistics organization, is a government corporation under the supervision of the Ministry of Health. Our mandate, basically speaking, is medical logistics. So we do all that pertains to logistics, from procurement, warehousing, distribution. We support the county governments. We also support the national government and the county government in collecting consumption data across the board, not only for nutrition. And we help the county governments in building supply chain capacity. This particular aspect we have not done very well, and there is some initiative between UNICEF and KEMSA in coming up with a system where we can build supply chain capacity in the counties, and I'll talk a little about it in a little while. In terms of what we do, in terms of who we are, I said we are medical logistics, and therefore, basically speaking, that's what we do. We warehouse, we distribute, after we have procured, and we offer supply chain services to over 13 strategic partners, including UNICEF. So when we talk about KEMSA, people think KEMSA is there to buy for government, warehouse for government. I will tell you, Werner, that in this warehouse, in the services that we give, the government of Kenya constitutes less than 20% of what we do. The rest of what we do is what we do for our own as a corporation, KEMSA, and a big chunk of it is what we do with our strategic partners, UNICEF, USAID, the Global Fund, UNFPA, who are the others? And very many others, the World Bank, Danida, and the others. That's basically what we do. And to be able to discharge the services that we are mandated to discharge, we have entered into partnerships with all the 47 counties. You know, Kenya is in a devolved system. We have 47 counties. And in addition to the 47 counties, we have the various key strategic partners. I will not go through them. You can see them on the screen. I cannot fail to highlight UNICEF, because we are here to celebrate our partnership. UNICEF, another very key partner is USAID. Sorry to say, USAID is the biggest partner in terms of funding that we have. I think the funding at the USAID is over $700 million. Then we have World Bank and Global Fund and the others. And we value these partnerships, and KEMSA is what it is today because of these strategic partnerships. I keep saying, without these strategic partnerships, the KEMSA we see today would not be there today. I'm not trying to insinuate that the government has not done its role. The government has perfectly done its role. But the capacity building, skills transfer, and the benchmarking with the strategic partners has played a very great role in the transformation of this organization. In terms of supply chain, we have supply chain infrastructure. I will not go into the details. We have warehouses across the country, in various regions of the country. We have a total of 8 regional warehouses. Allow me not to go into the details. I know you just asked me whether we have a warehouse in Turkana. I said we do not have. But within that region, we have a regional warehouse at Nakuru. but Nakuru is not near Turkana. But in Turkana specifically, we do not have. And we have tried to do some strategic network optimization. Where should we locate a warehouse? And at the moment, the cost-benefit analysis does not warrant a warehouse in Turkana at the moment. But I'm not saying for the future, I'm saying at the moment, and many other regions. Once we warehouse, of course, we distribute the commodities to where we are doing. At the moment, we are having a discussion with UNICEF. And the discussion we are having with UNICEF is making sure that we have the most optimal and cost-effective distribution or transportation services to the point of use or where they are needed. And since our core business is medical logistics, we leave the transportation to specialized outsourced transporters. These specialized outsourced transporters are sourced competitively through a tendering process, and they have to meet a certain minimum criteria to qualify to be our transporters. And we have different transporters for different regions of the country. We have basically cut the country into three regions, and each region has a transporter. And those are the details you learn. I'm sure this is not your first visit in KEMSA. And as we do go about making sure that we take the nutritional supplements and other commodities where they are needed, one critical aspect that we always uphold is the quality assurance aspect. And our quality assurance department is the most important department we have, and they have veto powers across the board, because not only they participate in ensuring that we receive quality products, but even at the procurement stage, they're involved. In the warehousing, they're involved. In the receipt, they're involved. And even when those commodities leave the warehouse, they follow them in the field randomly. They do random sampling. They have mini labs, the ones you put on the back of the pickups, and they do random testing to ensure that any commodity that has been warehoused and distributed by KEMSA maintains its integrity in terms of quality throughout its life in the supply chain. That's a service that we cannot compromise. And to ensure that we are talking to our customers and we have information flow from top to bottom and from bottom to top, we have the team that is headed by Jacqueline. She was just introduced shortly, our sales and marketing manager. We have the customer service officers headed by Dr. Warukana. The customer service officers sit here in Nairobi, centrally, but the sales and marketing officers are all over the counties. They interact with the customers, they interact with the health managers, they interact with the county health officials, to ensure that their needs and their wants are identified and addressed, and making sure that if there are any issues in terms of logistics, in terms of needs, they are properly catered for by the sales and marketing personnel under the leadership of Elliot. And when we are talking about the clientele, that's a map of Kenya showing a geomap showing the location of the facilities I'm talking about. These facilities number approximately 6,000, but in addition, I want to mention, we have not put on the map, we have another 5,400 HIV testing sites that we support on behalf of the US government. So those are the customers that we serve. And to be able to do this function, we have to have structures and systems that allow us to give efficient service delivery. And for that reason, we have fully automated our operations and an enterprise resource planning system, the ERP. And our ERP ensures that we have modules for every business function, all interconnected and talking to each other to ensure that we give an efficient service delivery, and cost effectiveness in whatever we do. We have just been taken through the LMIS, the Logistics Management Information System. This is the web-based self-service portal through which all the counties and health facilities are able to order their requirements online from the comfort of their offices, the comfort of their dispensaries, hospitals, and if need be, from the comfort of their sitting rooms if they wish. And this facility, the LMIS, is connected to all the 47 counties, and therefore there is no county that has no access. And since it has already been talked about, I will not say much about it. I think we have already been told much about the LMIS. I will also not talk about what is on that slide because I think we have been told by the two able ladies and gentlemen what the LMIS does. And I will just want to talk about how KEMSA goes about doing its business. KEMSA's business model is based on a supermarket model. I mentioned when we took tea. We are a supermarket, and supermarkets are everywhere in the world. So it is the same concept. In this supermarket behind you, the big building that you are going to have a tour of, we have all variety of commodities, and the commodities we have there are based on the needs of our customers. We have KEMSA procured commodities. These are the essential medicines based on the needs and the wants of the counties. We have other specialized requirements, like what UNICEF is supporting, nutritional supplements for specific needs and for specific counties. We have the antiretroviral supported by the US government and Global Fund, TB, and other specialized products that we support, and we give services that are supported by various partners. We also have products procured by the government of Kenya for specific needs, and all these form the supermarket.